right. Nat, you guys are coming back after kind of a long, extended time away from the ice. What's it kind of been like over the last week, just kind of getting back into the swing of things with this team, getting ready for obviously a very big series coming up this weekend?
I think over the break, we just like had a really good time off with our families and stuff. So it was really helpful to kind of take some time off. And now we are back at it again, excited to go back and, you know, play some games and just get back into it. It's been a bit slower start, but I think that's what we expected. But now we are all good, ready to go.
With front-loading the season with some of those tough road trips you guys have been on, and hopefully some more home matchups sprinkled in towards the end of the year, does that make it, I guess, a little bit easier to make that adjustment now that you guys have really been battle-tested in that first semester?
I don't know if easier is the right word. I would just say, like, we are really excited to come back and actually, like, play again because, as you said, like, we've already played, like, lots of games and it's always been fun to play games and, you know, we are just excited to play more.
Providence is obviously a team that you guys have had a pretty good rivalry with over the last couple of years. You guys knocked them out in the playoffs last year. What do you kind of know about playing against the Friars and how you guys kind of getting ready to counter what they do?
They are a very good team and, you know, we've seen it in their results this year for sure. And, like, they have lots of experience, lots of fifth years coming back. And as Jim mentioned, some Europeans and, you know, some transfers there too. So I think it's going to be really hard, but it's going to bring up a really good matchup for us. And I think we are ready to go.
Does it create any different kind of feeling for you guys as a team to play them three games in a row, like knowing that you're going to be battling against the same girls over and over and over?
Yeah, I mean, I've never experienced it personally before, so I don't even know how that feels like or how it looks like. It's definitely going to be a tough go back, but, you know, we just going is the same for the other team as well, so we are just going to go with what we have.
Almost a month off between games at this point for you guys. How do you kind of knock off some of the rust in these training sessions before you get to the puck drop in the first period? So I guess it kind of makes that a little bit easier.
I would say the first practices are always a bit tougher to go back and get back into the same schedule and, you know, in the training program. But I think what's just important is, like, recovery and, like, good nutrition, good sleep. And I think we've been doing pretty good. And, you know, as long as we are ready to go on Friday, it's all good.
How do you feel like the team's conditioning is right now? Do you feel like you guys kept up, like, muscle over the break and didn't really wear down that much?
I think the break was well deserved. I would just say we took some time off and it's never bad to you know, kind of turn off your mind of everything and, you know, spend time with families and just like chill for a bit. But yeah, like I think it's been more helpful than hurtful. So we will see how it goes.
This is a mashup of two teams that are ranked in the top 15, something that the program had never really done kind of until last year. Having played in those games with your teammates, obviously you've had some other very important games playing for your country as well, but how much do you think kind of the experience in those big games helps you guys come into this situation knowing that you're not really going to be overwhelmed by the moment?
Yeah, I think it definitely helps us to grow, like in general, like all of the games in the season at the end of the day, like in the final quarter of the season, like you just, you know, you kind of put it all together and you get all the experience and you all just put it together in one package and then you go from there. But yeah, I think it definitely helps to like play those big games and you know, either get experience or just learn from your mistakes or even like the other team mistakes and yeah, just go from there.
Jim kind of talked about how you guys have been scoring at a very high rate. You, of course, a big reason why, both scoring and assisting on goals in that first half of the season. How hard is it to kind of have that, I guess, chemistry on ice with your line mates and, you know, for the rest of the team when you have such a big break like that? Is it something that you kind of just pick up right away or does it take some time?
I feel like we've kind of picked it up where we left it out, honestly. Like, it was 2 weeks maybe that we actually had off and, you know, like, it's just the same thing. Like, the system is the same. Like, nothing has really changed and we are all pretty skilled players, I would say, and, you know, we just play together, like, obviously communication helps a lot, and, yeah, I wouldn't say it's been, like, any catchy by any means, but I also think it's the same for the other teams as well, because everybody had a break, so, yeah.
this, I guess, second portion of the season, from your point of view, what's, like, the big thing that you feel like you guys need to do to make that jump, contend for the top of the Hockey East, and then, you know, hopefully be playing some meaningful hockey into the end of the school year?
I would say just keep growing our game. Obviously keep doing the right things that we are doing and try to learn from the mistakes. And, you know, we talked about earlier how we need to work more on our defensive side of the game. And I think we've been doing that pretty well since then. And we are trying to really focus on the little things. And, you know, I believe that at the end of the day, it's all going to fall into its place.
Cool. Thanks,
appreciate it, Natalie.